Okay, so in this class, we're going to cover how to insert page break within WPS Office Suite. So to start with, all you need is to come anywhere within your document that you intend to insert a page break. You can just come over, assuming in this page, I want to insert a page break at this moment, at this point. So all you need is to come to insert over here. There are two ways to access page breaks within WPS. The first one is at the insert menu. You can see it over here where you have different kind of page breaks. You can break page break, which is the default one. Okay, you can see page break directly, or you can do column break in cases when you are working with multiple columns, and you can do text wrapping break in cases if you want to break from a text wrap to another section. Okay, so you can do next page section break, you can do start a new section at a new page break, okay, or continuous section page break, and even page section page break. You can do all this if you so wish. And another way to access page break is by coming to page layout, and you can see it over here, breaks. Okay, so you can access the same page break from this angle as well. So for this one, we can just stay at the insert menu, assuming you want to create a page break at this moment, at this point. All you need is to come to breaks, and you can come over to page break over here, and you can see it has broken the page from this moment, and everything now move to the next page. Okay, from this point that we created the page, it moves to the next page. You can try to view that by making this smaller, and maybe you can come to view and say maybe you want to view multiple pages, assuming I want to make it multiple page. So it becomes very easy. So if I want to break at this point, all I need is to come to the same insert and go to breaks and still create break, page break, and you can see it has broken from this page to this page, this point. Okay, so it's very easy and very nice, and in cases when you want to just see how you can play around with your text, you can play around with it. And in cases when you want to see where there are page breaks within your document, all you need is to come back to the home tab over here, and you can come to this icon, this very small one that is called show hide editing marks in WPS. So if you click on this small drop down, you can come over here and say show or hide paragraph marks. Once you click on show or hide paragraph marks, you will see the exact places where there are page breaks. So for example, at this moment there is a page break over here, and there's another page break over here, and it broke into this point. Okay, so if at any given point you decide to remove page breaks from your document, you can still see that at this point you have a page break. So all you need is just select the page break and delete, and then the document is back to normal. Select this one also and delete, and the document is back to where it was before. So it's very, very easy feature to use. And at any given point, you can still come back and unshow this so that you can have your document fully. The reason for that is to show all the tabs and the spacing and characters in between the words. Okay, so I think you can just go ahead and play around with the page break options and try it on your own in any other way you want to play around with it. But I think that does it for this tutorial on how to use page break. So thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next class.